Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about recursive function. What do you mean by recursive function? A function calling itself means then you call that particular function as recursive function. It is actually calling execution instance of its own. That is what recursive function. For what kind of problems you can go for recursive function means, if a problem can be breakdown into similar kind of sub problems, then you can go for your recursive function. To go for recursive function, you have to find two things. First, you have to find recursive formula. Then you have to find the base condition. What is this recursive formula means? You have to check whether it is possible to find a similar sub problem from the original problem. If you are able to find, that is your recursive formula. What is that base condition? You have to break the sub problem into a stage until it can be directly solved. This directly solved condition you call it as base function. If you are able to identify these two things for a problem, you can go for recursive functions. To explain it, we will take a factorial problem as example. Okay, first we see whether it is possible to find recursive formula and how to decompose your n factorial problem. N factorial is nothing but n into n minus 1 till you find it goes till your 1. That is, if you want to find 3 factorial, 3 factorial is nothing but 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, from this what we can infer is this portion is nothing but n minus 1 factorial. Right, now I have got recursive formula. My original problem has been breakdown into similar kind of sub problem. So how to find the base condition? For finding base condition, you have to break down the large problem until you get actual solution, after which you cannot further subdivide. See, on writing your recursive formula, when you expand it, you can expand n minus 1 as n minus 1 factorial as n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial, n minus 2 factorial as n minus 2 into n minus 3 factorial. This could be proceeded until you reach 1 factorial. 1 factorial is nothing but 1. So this is your base condition. With this understanding, we will go for function designer. See, here you have designed a function for computing your factorial. So if the value is n, you can directly return the factorial value as 1. So this is the base condition. You apply recursive formula only when the value of n is greater than 1. So I am going for the condition, if the value is greater than 1, what I have to do? I have to do n into n minus 1 factorial. To compute n minus 1 factorial, I am calling the same function. I am making use of the same function, but the value what I am going to pass as argument is n minus 1. At one point of time it will reach 1 and I will get the base value. We will see how this function executes. If I am going to call this function with the value as 3, the 3 will be copied over here, right? It will first check whether I have reached the base condition. No, so you go for the next stage and you call n into n minus fact of n minus 1, that is 3 into fact of 2. Now the function is called again with n value as 2. The another instance starts running. Now you check whether you reach the base condition. No, so you go for the next statement and you call n into fact of n minus 1, so which is nothing but fact of 1. So another instance of the same function is called. Now you have reached the base condition. That means you are going to return 1. This value 1 is returned over to the called function. So it will compute 2 into 1, 2, and it will return back to its own caller. So here you will get 2. So 3 into 2, 6. So it will return to the main function. That is, it will return over here and you will get printed as 3 factorial as 6.